Hello, I'm John Casebolt with Equipment Technologies. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Diagnostic app on your Apache sprayer. We're going to be taking a look at the Apache Diagnostics app and look at some of the features that will allow us to understand some of the electrical issues the machine may be having and take the proper approach to maintain or repair them so that the machine will function correctly. To get to the Diagnostics app, we're going to start with our main run screen. We're going to swipe from right to left one time and we'll see the Diagnostics app button come up at the top of the screen. Touching the button, the first page that we come to shows our diagnostic faults. If we look in our fault history, we see that we have no fault history, nor do we have any active faults. But I'm going to flip a switch right now that's going to allow us to introduce an active fault so that we can see what that looks like. When the fault comes up, there's going to be a message telling us that we've got a cab problem, and then I can silence that and go back and take a look at it later. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and enlarge that cab circuit fault so I can see what it's telling me. And it says that I've got a problem with my cab roof power circuit. My voltage is below normal or shorted to a low source. I need to check a fuse, a 10 amp fuse. So we're going to go down and take a look at the fuse. Once we've looked at that fuse circuit, maybe we've determined we do have a blown fuse. So we replace the fuse, and after having replaced the fuse, we come back to take a look and see whether or not that active fault goes away. It takes a few seconds for an active fault to come up. It takes a few seconds for an active fault to disappear. Now that I've replaced the fuse, I can see that there's no longer an active fault, but if I go into my fault history, I can see that fault occurred, how many times, and the last time it occurred as far as the number of engine hours are concerned. So what I want to do as a person who owns a machine, I may want to keep track of these faults so I can have a history of what's happened. I may want to say, okay, at this point, I don't want to have a history in the machine. I just want to be able to start with a clean slate so I can go in and tell that I want to clear my history. And it's going to say, do you really want to clear your history? Yes, of course I do. And so now I have no fault history, I have no active faults, but I had a message that came up that let me know where the problem was at, where I needed to go look at it, and what I could do to try and correct it. Now we're going to swipe over to the second page of our Diagnostics app, and we have a number of parameters here that we can look at, and we're just going to stay on the machine parameters for now, but we can take a look at our ambient temperature. Our cab temperature is an interesting one for us to be able to see if we're having trouble with our heating and air conditioning in the cab, and we want to see what the actual temperature in the cab is. We can come in here and look at our cabin air temperature and see what it's telling us. We can come down and see what our actual engine coolant temperature is, what our transmission oil temperature is. I can take a look and see what my water valve duty cycle is. If I'm questioning whether or not my heating system is working, whether or not that valve's opening and closing as it's supposed to be doing. So that's some information that we can get from our diagnostics parameters. If I swipe over one more page, I have a feature here that allows me to turn on and turn off my automatic fan control, or I can set the timer on that so that if I'm running in dustier conditions, my fan will automatically reverse to help clean out the radiator, the cooling package, and I can increase the amount of time that will take to do that, or I can decrease it. It depends on how dusty the conditions are. So I can turn my auto reverse feature on by touching that button. It's now highlighted in red. I've got a button down here that I can use to turn it off and on with, and then I can slide my bar down at the bottom where I can have it come on every quarter of an hour or every 15 minutes, or if it's not very dusty and I don't want to come on that often, I can move that bar out to where I can increase my time to an hour and a half. So it just depends on the circumstances. If I've been running with it an hour and a half, but then I get to running on some dry days and it's just dustier out. I'm collecting more dirt and contaminants in my cooling package than what I want. I can come into this part of the Diagnostics app. I can set that where it'll come on every half hour. And now my fan will automatically reverse, and it will help clean out that cooling package so that the cooling system will be able to function correctly. And then finally, I get over to the fourth page of my Diagnostics app, and I can see if I've got communication between all the processors on the machine. I can go to, this just gives me a quick look. I can go to a full screen, which takes me to my system map and allows me to see each of the processors on the electrical system and whether or not they are connected. If they all have a green circle with a white check mark, then they're all connected and talking. If I go back to another one of my buttons and take a look at, for instance, the joystick. If I want to take a look at the joystick, I've got my auto steer won't engage for some reason, but I want to see if my steering button is working on my joystick. I can touch my joystick button and I can see the button lighting up on the display, so I know that button is working. So those button touches are useful to let me know whether or not I have a button that's not working correctly, or do I have another electrical problem that I need to go look at and try to repair. The same thing is true with my armrest keypad. You see where it's has my HVAC controls, my boom fold controls, my pump controls, my auto cruise controls are all represented in this diagram. And I'm able to see that it's connected. So now if I have a problem, for instance, with my pump not wanting to turn on, I can touch my pump button and I can see again that button light up, which will tell me that my pump switch is working. That part's communicating. I can go somewhere else to look for my problem. So that's the type of things that we can do with the Diagnostic app, and we can do those with each controller that we have on the machine. If we look at the display, we can see that it's connected. We can also see what our software version is. We can see whether or not there's any fault history associated with the display. We can do the same thing with our engine controller. What's the software version? What's our engine serial number? What's our total engine hours? And what's our total idle hours? If we're interested in comparing our idle hours to our total engine hours to see how efficient we're being with our machine. There's a number of things that we can look at in that Diagnostics app that will allow us to be able to understand better how our machine's operating and functioning, and perhaps be able to take care of a problem as it arises, even if it's an intermittent issue. And that's one of the things that's most difficult for an operator or for a service technician. I have a problem that happens and then it doesn't happen. It breaks and then it starts working again. And so sometimes when I'm driving the machine and I have a problem that occurs, I can come in here quickly and take a look at my system map, and I can see if I have a problem with one of these processors that's gone offline. That may help lead me to understand better what's going on with the machine so that I can make appropriate repair, or at least share that information with the service technician. Thanks for watching. If you have other questions about using the ET Diagnostic app on your Apache sprayer, please contact your Apache dealer.